Hi everyone, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ash and this is Yousef Chowdhury. Today we are going to work on Yoast part 2 of 4. So if you didn't see the first part, we're going to put the link in the description box below, or possibly even maybe just like right here. We'll go ahead and put that. So pause this video, go click on that link, get over there and see how to install Yoast. Yousef's going to walk you through that. But before we get started today, we want to mention our awesome sponsors for our classes here at WebTegrity. We've got WP Engine, WP Elevation. It's over here. No, it's over here. Point to this side. And WP 101. It's mirrored. It's weird.
Yeah, it's like right there.
There you go. Yeah. All of these awesome sponsors, we want to brag about them and tell you that if you're using WordPress, you need to be aware of all three of these great organizations. WP Engine offers really awesome hosting. WP Elevation gives incredible tracks. It's Troy down in Australia. He's got a cool accent to listen to as well. And WP 101 walks you through some amazing free WordPress tutorials, as well as some paid that are totally worth the small amount that you'd be paying to access all of their amazing video tutorial library. So without further ado, Yousef is going to walk you through Yoast
part two. Yes. Thank you. Oh, I've been like living here. No, I'm just kidding. All right. I'm about to take over again. It feels good to take over. All right, folks. So in our last video, I talked about basically on what is on-site SEO and how to install the Yoast plugin. Today, what I'm going to talk about, and make sure you have, you know, pen and paper to write it down, is how to do keyword research. First, go to adwords.google.com/keyword planner and log in with your Gmail. So I'm gonna log in with my Gmail right here. Okay. I'm gonna share with you a few tips on how to do a proper keyword research. So once you log in, come on, hurry, just a moment. There you go. So this is how the keyword planner looks like. You have 4 options. Don't worry about the second, third, and the fourth for now. Just stick with the first one right here, which is to search for new keyword and group ideas. So you select this part. Okay. Once you do that, here you can put several key phrases or just one keyword, is up to you. For Corey's website, I'm going to use a CSS. Let's see, CSS for, beginners, your landing page. If you have a landing page, you can put the link there, but if you don't, just don't worry about it, leave it as it is. Category, this basically means what kind of niche you are in. It's optional. If you want to select it, that's fine. If you don't, that's up to you. And here, by default, you should have all countries or United States. I automatically picked San Antonio because I want to find out what people in San Antonio search for let's say my product and services. So I left it to San Antonio. So when you click this edit, you can go ahead and select the city that you want to do the keyword research for. All languages, I leave it as it is by default in Google. Everything else, just leave it as it is for now because it's just the basic. Then I'm gonna go ahead and click on get ideas. And there you go. So by default, the ad group ideas will be selected. I don't have to look at this one because this is mostly for Google AdWord, like the PPC. As you can see, for web design, oh my God, look at that. $17 per click, woo! Okay, let me just go ahead and click on keyword ideas. Click on the keyword ideas. This is what you need to look for. Here, as you can see, for that keyword that I was searching for, CSS for beginners, Google gave me 800 variation of that one key phrase. Okay, and it tells you like in what month is very popular and whatnot, and it gives you the average monthly searches. So what you do right now, don't look at the numbers, don't look at the competition, don't even look at the prices right now. What you need to look for is the relevancy. What I mean by that, is this keyword relevant to what you provide? Is it relevant to what kind of product and services you offer? Can it be used for your blog? So right now you have 800 of them. So what you do, you click download and download that keyword as an Excel file. Okay, so make sure, number one, that you have to look for relevancy, right? So you're going to download those 800 keywords. It will open up in an Excel file, Excel sheet. So let me see if I can open it. There you go. This is a CSV file, but if you have an Excel document, it will basically show you the seed keyword. This is the main keyword that I search for, and the keyword ideas is the variation of the other key phrases. You can ignore all these options on this side. What you have to do right now, go through every single key phrase or keyword and remove the irrelevant key phrases. Key phrases or keyword that doesn't match to your product and services, remove them, and that's it. So out of the 800, if you end up having, let's say, 300, then we can use, let's say, if you have 10 pages on your website, if you have like 5 or 10 pages, you will pick top 10 out of the 300, and the rest of the other key phrases and keyword, you can use it for like using it for blog posts, hashtags, social media, podcasts, and videos and whatnot, okay? So I hope this is helpful. Let me know if you have any more questions. In our video part 3 next time, we will show you how you can take some of these key phrases and optimize every single page on your website for the pages and also for the blog post. I hope this was beneficial. So please, if you have any question, go ahead and ask and also comment below. Thank you. We'll see you next time.